Hey Kansas City Chiefs fans, it's BJ Kissel again with another video for the Arrowhead Pride YouTube channel. Now today we're obviously going to be talking about the Chiefs' 7th round pick, the wide receiver from Michigan, Junior Hemingway. Now I had a chance to go back and watch the Michigan Northwestern game from last season, and I took 4 plays out of that game that Junior Hemingway had that kind of caught my eye as far as what he can do and different ways that Michigan used him that hopefully can translate over to the Chiefs. So in this first play, you're going to notice that Hemingway is lined up at the top of the screen in the slot, and as soon as the ball is snapped, you're going to see him go off on his route, and he's going to get one-on-one coverage down the field. Denard Robinson, Michigan's quarterback, realizes this, chucks up the ball, and Hemingway makes a great play to come down with the ball. The interesting thing about Hemingway is he doesn't have like John Baldwin's, 6'5" stature. He's just over 6 feet tall, but he still has the ability to go up and make a play down the field in a one-on-one situation. He has great control over his body. He has great hands. So it's just an example of the way that he can use his body to kind of make up for the fact that he doesn't have those 5 or 6 inches of height that John Baldwin has. But definitely a great example of him going out and making a play. Now the second play is going to be a little more detail oriented. I know one of the things that we talked about in the last video with Devin Wiley was his route running ability and the sharpness and quickness he comes out of his routes. Now in the second play, you're going to see him in the slot. He's on the first view, it's just going to look like a basic play where he gets open down the field, gets a 10-15 yards after the catch for a big game. But when you watch the second replay, when he runs his route, one of the things you're going to notice is that when he sells the double move, it's not just his footwork and the sharpness of his route. It's when he turns his head to the inside, that's what causes the safety to break as if to think that the ball was going to come to the inside, and then he cut outside, and it definitely opened up the play for him, and it's kind of what sold the play and made it work. Now, is Hemingway the only wide receiver that does this? No. But it is a perfect example of why they are taught to do that and why turning the head does help sell the play. To any young receiver out there, this is why your coaches are telling you to do this. And then in this third play, what you're going to notice, and this is a little bit about how Michigan used him and moved him around, and when there was big situations, they wanted to get the ball in Hemingway's hands. In this game, Michigan didn't really play well in the first half. They were actually struggling quite a bit offensively and defensively as a whole. They were trailing in this game at this point in time. It was 3rd and 6, a pretty big situation at the time. And you can see that Hemingway started off lined up next to Denard Robinson in the shotgun, and then motions out, gets the matchup I think Michigan was looking for, where he's up on a linebacker. And as soon as the ball snapped, you're going to see Robinson just stare him down the entire time until he gets open. He actually throws the ball into traffic. I think there were 3 defenders around there. But definitely, they wanted to make sure that Hemingway got the ball in his hands because he's the guy they wanted to go to in that situation, and made a good play. So, and then in this last play, what you're going to see is another big third down situation. This time it's a little bit longer, 3rd and long, and Michigan finds a way to get Hemingway the ball. And when you watch the second replay, one of the things that you're going to notice is Hemingway had a chance to break off his route sooner, as there was a defender kind of impeding his progress as he was running. But he breaks it off to give himself enough room between, I think, about the hash mark and the sideline, to where he wanted to give himself enough room to where when he breaks off to the outside, that he had room for Robinson to make the pass. And you can kind of see that when you watch the replay, where he gives himself enough room, comes down with the play, keeps his feet in bounds, makes a great play for Michigan. And just another example of when they needed to make a big play, when it was third down, they were looking to go to Hemingway. And for the Chiefs to get a guy that was the go-to wide receiver for a top 15 program that had a shaky offense. Now, Denard Robinson's a good quarterback, but a lot about what people talk about with him is his athletic ability and running the ball, not necessarily sitting back as a passer and just picking people apart. So to get a guy that was the go-to wide receiver for a top program like that in a big conference, to get a guy like that in the 7th round is a huge steal for the Chiefs. So it's definitely a pick that I'm excited about. I'm personally a huge fan of his coach at Michigan, Brady Hoke. My wife and I live in San Diego, and when we first moved down here, when he was the coach at San Diego State, my wife was working in the athletic department. I had a chance to talk with Brady Hoke and his wife several different times. They're very good people, and I'm excited that not only did we get Hemingway and being a good player, but we got him coming from a coach that I really do respect and like a lot. And I think that Hemingway is going to have to prove his worth on special teams as a rookie, as are most skilled position players that are taken late in the draft, especially early in their career as they develop as wide receivers. But I think he has all the ability to make a difference for the Chiefs, and hopefully he can prove his special team's worth and get out on the field as a rookie. So I'm looking for big things from him. For the new Arrowhead Pride YouTube channel, I'm BJ Kissel.